Welcome to the User Interface video series. This tutorial describes the unit functionality available in the GeoStudio products, particularly the ability to modify the units on all parameters within a project file. In GeoStudio, units may be modified in the Units dialog. The Unit dialog box differentiates between base and derived units. The base units listed at the top of this window are the fundamental units from which all other units are derived. As such, a change to a base unit affects all derived units in a consistent manner. For example, when establishing a transient analysis over a long duration, it is typically desirable to specify the base unit for time in terms of days as opposed to seconds. Consequently, the units on all time-based parameters such as acceleration and water flux are automatically converted to be consistent with the modified base unit. However, the derived units on some parameters may be unintuitive or inconvenient for the purposes of defining material properties or boundary conditions. For example, it may be more convenient to define time-based hydraulic or thermal properties in terms of seconds instead of days. To accommodate these requirements, the derived unit for any parameter can be uniquely specified. A comprehensive list of the parameters with derived units is available in the bottom portion of the Units dialog box. This functionality offers a great deal of flexibility for defining the units. Finally, when the units are modified in the Units dialog, all user-defined constants and functional values like the material properties are automatically converted into the new unit format. In GeoStudio, the system of units associated with a project is specified by going to Define, Project Properties, and selecting the Settings tab. The system of units may be either the International System of Units or US Customary Units. The base and derived units are found under View, Units. The parameter units initially correspond to the selected system of units. In the Units dialog, if we modify a base unit, then the derived units are also modified accordingly. Or, if it is desirable to modify the units associated with a single parameter, we may do so using the list of derived units. For example, if we measured the thermal conductivity of the soil in the laboratory in terms of joules instead of kilojoules, we can select this parameter and change the associated energy units from kilojoules to joules. It is also important to note that in this analysis, the base time units are seconds. However, the time definition, as visible in the Analysis Explorer, is in days. This is because the unit definition for time in the derived units list was modified to days. The unit functionality is also accessible from other dialog boxes in both the definition and results views. For example, in the Define Materials window, when we right-click on a parameter, we are given the option to change that parameter's units. This option opens the Units dialog box and automatically selects the appropriate parameter in the derived units list. We may also access the Units dialog from a Material Function window. For example, we can change the units of the y-intercept. The same features are available in the Define Boundary Conditions window. When entering a parameter value, we may also input a value associated with a different unit, and GeoStudio will automatically convert the entered value so it is consistent with the base or derived unit specified for that parameter. For example, if the total head for the right boundary condition was measured in centimeters instead of meters, we can enter this value including the centimeter units. After pressing Enter, the value is converted so it is in terms of the specified base units, meters. This may be particularly helpful when defining the time steps for an analysis. Accessibility to the Units dialog is also available from windows in the Results view. For example, if we open the Draw Graph window, we may also access the Units dialog to modify the units of the X and Y axes by right-clicking within the Graph window and selecting the units we wish to change. Finally, when a base unit is modified in the Units dialog after the analysis properties have already been defined, all the entered values are automatically updated. If I change the base unit for length to millimeters, then open the Define Boundary Conditions window, I can see that the total head boundary condition values were updated accordingly. This was not the case in the past, which meant that every inputted value had to be manually updated when the units were changed. In summary, the units dialog allows for the modification of both base and derived units, providing a simple, flexible method for defining the units. Previously entered parameter values are automatically updated when units are modified. Finally, the units dialog is accessible from windows in both the definition and results views, wherever units appear. For more information on GeoStudio and its features, please look at the example files and other tutorial videos on the GeoSLOPE website. Thank you for watching.